Hello, this is Lumen May. We're here at May's Message with Claire Long, Director of Human Services. Claire has taken over Human Services, and I believe one of the greatest investments is in human capital. And one of the many things that Claire assists with is going out, and whether we're doing Christmas giveaways, or whether we're doing feedings at Brownsville, or bike giveaways at Brownsville, or buying toys, we take our discretionary money. And we actually want to see it. We want to come out and see the children. But we're able to get gifts, and that coordination came because of Claire, working with On Bikes, working with Community Caring.
I love helping the children, and I just love coming out and supporting the events that Commissioner May put on, and just giving back. And it's all about giving back to the community, and that's what we do.
And you don't have to be, a director. You don't have to buy a lot of toys or get a lot of bikes. Everybody can give something. You can give your time, your talent, and then this holiday season, if it's something, just picking up the phone and calling an elderly person or seeing a young person who's out of school for 2 weeks and making sure that they get an apple and an orange. And Claire, that's something that we do. I mean, we buy fruit and apples and oranges when kids are out.
Absolutely, we do it all, Commission. We have food available for children. We have study groups. We just do everything. Anything to help the children in any way we can, that's what we're here for.
The greatest difference you can make is making a difference in the life of a child. Thank you. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays. We love y'all. High five. Hello, this is Lumen May County Commission District 3. We're here at the Bay Center, and we've been to Brownsville, we've been to Oak Crest, we've been to Lincoln Park doing our annual Christmas giveaways. We're excited today because not only are we going to be able to give out toys with our partners, at Community Caring and On Bikes Pensacola, but also what's near and dear to me, we're going to be able to reward some young people for the academic and athletic achievement, at the same time recognizing children who've excelled here in District 3. And so, again, we know that we can't service every single child in District 3, but hopefully throughout this week, we've made some children happy, we've brightened their life, we've shown them that someone really cares. And so, really today, in the last week and a half, whether we're in the schools, whether in the community center, is really about sharing is caring. It's really about letting our children know that we truly love them. And so you don't have to be able to do big grand events like this, but you can help a niece, a nephew, you can help a child in your neighborhood, you can give them a gift. It doesn't have to be a gift of money, it doesn't have to be a toy, it can be just a gift of love. And so today we want to share love, share gifts, share happiness to all. And again, on behalf of Lumen May County Commission District 3, Merry Christmas and thank you for joining us. So we're going to ask, everybody's going to get an opportunity to be recognized. Everybody is going to get an opportunity to get a gift if they're on their best behavior. Everybody deserves to be recognized. We want everybody to have a gift, but everybody deserves respect. So parents, we need your help. That's all I'm using. That's amazing. We need your help, and we want to make sure that we're welcome back to the Bay Center. We were not here last year. If any of you missed the banquet on last week and the toy giveaway, it was great. Some great testimonials from Coach Maurice and Coach Tamika and Coach Terrell. But whether you go to Montclair or Lincoln Park, or whether you live in Brownsville, or whether you live on Gregory Street or Lincoln Park or Wedgwood, we're all one family. And so we're excited about doing this. And parents, I'll tell you, we want to recognize people. We worked very hard to organize this. We couldn't do it without help from Leroy. And Leroy, thank you for being here and your work. Our partners on Bikes and Sue Strong and Community Caring and Ray Palm and Terrell. A lot of money has been spent today. A lot of effort has been put into it because we believe, I believe that the children in District 3 are the best children. And the children in SYSA are the very best children. And so when we ask to give, of their best, we're going to give them the very best that we can give them. We make no apologies for the position that we take. And people can make a decision to be here or not be here, but those who decide to join us, we certainly want their children to recognize us. So, today, we're going to be mindful and respectful of others who are getting awards and speaking. I can do little babies, but when you're over the age of three, then you know to be quiet. But we certainly want to be very respectful. And parents, we are not substitute for good parenting. There's no way, if you can't make your child sit down and be quiet, if you can't make your child be respectful, if you can't make your child get a grade, a coach can't do it. It's not a coach responsibility. We're supplements to good parents. We're not substitutes. And so what I tell you young people, an uncoachable child is an unemployable adult. A rude child is an unemployable adult because you'll never be able to make it. And so today is about recognizing you, but also learning our mannerisms. Because the reason we do banquets and we just don't do drive-bys and cookouts for our children, the reason we do it is because if you're going to go to high school, if you're going to Pine Forest, you're playing the state, if you make it to the next level in your professional career or anywhere, you're going to be invited to banquets. They're going to expect for you to dress the proper way. Can't go and get a job with saggy pants and your hat tearing back. Just not the way it works. Those are just not the standards. And so what we expect is for us to give you those standards. Some people won't even recognize. Some people talk. Some people be playing their game. Somebody won't even care. The words that we say will just fall on deaf ears. But to those of you who care, those are the Terrell Haynes and the Brian Stalwart and the Ray Palmers and the Trays that come back and give back. And so we want our children to be successful. And with that, is Kenny Reed here? He's not here. Don't worry about it. I didn't want him to pray anyway. with that, we're going to bow our heads and do an invocation because Kenny's not here, just like his practice is always. Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for this opportunity. Thank you for the young people. Thank you for the parents that entrusted the lives of their children to us. Thank you for all those, and whether they're running around at community center, at Brownsville, or a football field at Legion, or rather, they're just working hard in their schoolwork. We want this day to be a day that they can be surely recognized. And when it's all said and done, we need to honor and praise. Amen. Now, we couldn't do this without the hard work of Ray Palmer. Everybody knows him. I mean, he's everywhere, whether it's girl basketball, football, whether it's being active in the community, or whether it's marching or going to city council meeting, fighting for children. I can tell you, I was with him Thursday night at a city council meeting fighting for children. And he's a person that fights behind the scenes, in front of the scenes for our children. Y'all please join to the mic, Mr. Raymond Palmer.
Coach Palmer always build me up, not letting down every time. No, we just want to welcome everybody here. I think we had a great football season this year. We won two championships. Every team went to the playoffs. I know y'all look at some of the other parts. Got 8, 9, 10 teams. Well, guess what? Guess how many championships they won? Two. Just like we won two. So it is what it is. We always gonna have team championships because I personally believe we have the best coaches in the city, along with the parents and players. And that really helps a lot. So when I call Coach Trey, you know, I try to grow a beard, but it get grayer and grayer, especially during football season. Especially after I talk to Coach Trey on the phone for 30 minutes. But you know what? I love it there. Because at the end of the day, it's all about the kids, along with the rest of our coaches. Coach Kenny Reed, you know, believe it or not, Coach Kenny Reed's coached me when I was a little boy. You know, he was a much, much harder then. Matter of fact, he cut my brother, and then I quit. And we walked home, we was in Lincoln Park, we got to the street. I was like, well, you gonna tell mom and daddy that? You quit and I quit? He said, no, you're going to tell us. I said, no, we finna turn around and go back and tell Coach Kenny, we sorry, can we get back on the team? I said, we ain't finna do that. But anyhow, I appreciate Coach Kenny, his staff, Coach Terrell. Y'all know how much I love Terrell. You know, one of the reasons why I still coach is because of Coach Terrell Hankins. I know there's some Terrell Hankins out there, but if anybody in this world can make it, there was nobody in this world had a heart than Coach Terrell Hankins. I'm here to tell you. I'm here to tell you, I know he gets tired of me telling the story, and his wife told me, please don't tell it no more, but he go home, they both cry all night, but Coach Real had a heart. He had no daddy. Well, he had one, he's in prison. His older brother, who we love, and ain't said nothing bad about him, had some problems. He was in a juvenile for a while. Terrell's mother, she had some bad, bad demons. So I would take Terrell home, and he would sit on the porch, and I'd be like, why Terrell didn't go in the house? Well, because Terrell didn't have no power. So Terrell would just sit outside and just wait, and I would drop him off at Lowe's and Fisher. That's the place with shelter like. Terrell would tell all the kids, my mama worked here, but his mama wasn't working there. Terrell was living there. And through all that, Terrell was the first kid at the center, always on the honor roll, and actually got an academic scholarship. Y'all give it up for Coach Terrell. So, Ken, when you tell me you got it rough, I want to hear it. But there was nobody rougher than Terrell, and he made it. So that tells me you can make it. You just have to put your mind to it. Be disciplined. Terrell was always disciplined. Whatever we said, I asked him, yes, sir, no, sir. New coach Bloomer gave him a job at like 12, 13 years old. That's what life's all about. You know, sports, I love sports. You don't go so far in sports. One day you got to stop playing sports. So if you play sports your whole life and you ain't got any education, any work skills, you're probably going to be in trouble. So I'm telling you guys, you know, get your job skills. I know y'all are so young, y'all don't even know what I'm talking about. He's like, what the heck is coach talking about? My mom and dad are working, I ain't got to work. But I'm telling you, when you get 18, mom and dad are kicking you out the house. You got to feed for your own. So start learning now. Start getting good work. If you're a good football player, you have good work ethic as a football player, you probably will be all right as an adult. So just keep that up. Once again, Coach Newman got the base center. And, he amazes me at some of the stuff he do. Like he said, we together last Thursday night. Down at City Council meeting, you know, fighting for SYSA and some stuff. But we're trying to get, we're trying to keep hold on. And it's all about the kids. Because the Newman kids are grown. Now I'm in the program. My baby's 22, I don't know what she is. But that's my youngest. I have no kids in the program. I have no grandkids in the program yet. It's all about you guys. So with that, let's have a good time tonight. We have a good banquet, and when we get out there on the skates, if you knock me down, you will not be able to play here no more at all. Especially if I get hurt.
Thank you, Coach Palmer, a true champion for the West Side, and John Adams will say a true champion for Lincoln Park, the heart of who we serve. So many times, young folks, we look up, and on last week, we had the 11, 12, 13, 14-year-old children here to really just have straight talk, to have them to listen at people and hear from Billy D. Williams and Maurice Dunn and Terrell Hankins about real-life challenges. You don't have to go looking to celebrities or anybody to find a role model. The role models are right in your home, they're right in your neighborhood, they're right on the coaching field. And sometimes you don't recognize the struggle that many of your coaches have gone through. Many of your coaches have been arrested. Many of your coaches have been on drugs. Many of your coaches have been divorced. Many of your coaches have come from single family homes. And so today, we're gonna let a few people share stories who are all near and dear to my heart because I know where they come from. And so. The first person is a young man that I knew, just like Terrell, we probably gave him a job when he was 12 years old. Not only has he gotten a job, and went in the military, beat all obstacles, and when they say men can't raise children, he was raised by his dad. Had a mom, had a grandma, but coaches became his family. He went on to start his own business, to give back. He hard-headed, he don't listen most of the time, but I tell you, he has a heart of gold of giving back. And wanting to make his family better and make his children better. So we're gonna first hear from the person we all know, Brian Stallwood. Brian.
Well, I didn't know I was gonna talk tonight, and Coach Walker said I was talking. But just like Coach Palmer, you know, said, just like, you know, what my brother went through, all of us have been through something, you know, something in life. Just like Coach Newman said, I was raised by my father, my grandfather, and my father. My grandfather, most of my life, my father's son, because everybody knows who my dad is. But, you know, like everyone, you know, all of us, 90% of us from the hood, you know. I was born at Addis Court, raised in Scammon, you know. Over the years, you know, just looked at people like Coach Newman, like Terrell, you know. I understood where he came through. Like Coach Palmer, normal guys had jobs. You know, Coach Newman, a business owner, which made me open my eyes and say, hey, you know, what's out there? what is there to do, you know? So I got into, I like video games, so I got into technology and things like that, ended up getting a master's degree in cybersecurity, which is, you know, what's going on right now. And then I ended up, you know, just like Coach Lumen, you know, hey, he had a construction business, hey, it's some stuff out there that can make you some money, and that's what I did. Took some money, invested, and started me a trucking business. But I say this, you know, just I want to keep my stuff quick and simple. Hey, anything you put your mind to, you know, you can ask Coach Lumen, you can ask Terrell, you can ask when Miss Samantha ain't here. When Miss Samantha was there about 4 o'clock in the morning. Coach Bennett, that's my guy right now today. You know, you can't tell me nothing bad about Coach Bennett, Coach Lumen, you can't tell me nothing bad about them guys. But he told me when I was in the ninth grade, I was not gonna play varsity football the next year if I didn't work out, if I didn't work hard. Every morning, ask Terrell. Every morning when they sold it to the Salvation Army, I had been there for 2 hours. I had been in the gym running. I had been in the pool, I had to swim 25 laps because we also had to be lifeguards. So, but I had to swim 25 laps. Built a little weight room in there. Me and Coach Bernard built the weight room, was lifting weights every day. But if anything you do, hard work is hard work. No matter if it's at the job, no matter if it's football, basketball, baseball, whatever you do, if you put your mind to it, you know, you can do it. You know, I'm just like everybody else, you know. I laugh, I play just like everybody else. You know, I have fun, normal guy. But just put your mind to it, kids. And the parents too, whatever you want to do, just put your mind to it, you can do it. Thank you.
Thanks, Ryan. Ryan truly is a success story, as Coach Palmer said, that he can make it. The next two people we're going to bring before we start awards, it touched my heart last week when they shared their story. Because when you really think you know somebody, you really don't. And when Coach Shamik and Coach Sherrill shared their story on last Sunday, I was in tears, and I was in tears all week because I said, sometimes, children, you think you got it rough, but you don't know what others are going to. So at this time, I'm going to call to the mic Shamika Hankins and Terrell Hankins. Coach Hankins. And they certainly did think that they were speaking again this week.
How y'all doing?
All right.
I'm going to go first because last weekend, my wife, I've heard her story, and we've been married 11 years now. But I've never heard her like tell other people. So I was caught off guard by most of the stuff, but I mean, just blown away at the same time. Like Coach Lumen said, I mean, I've had it rough in life, but that's never been like a setback for me. Because of this program, I mean, I never wanted to let Coach Palmer or Coach Lumen down, so I worked hard. That's all it is. I mean, I was able to get a scholarship, I was able to get a bachelor's degree, I was able to marry this fine thing right here. But, y'all know I want to sleep on the couch.
Get you off the couch tonight.
But other than that, just like Coach Brian said, fellas, y'all work hard in life. Put your all into whatever you set out to do, and you'll be successful. All right, that's it.
I'm just gonna be brief. The whole point of my story is there's gonna be things that come up, and there's gonna be decisions that you have to make as young ladies. And you don't have to bear those bad mistakes or decisions that you make. You can always push through those decisions, and if you want better for yourself, you can have better for yourself. So, like Terrell said, we've been married for 11 years. We have 9 kids together. Most people don't know that. We have 9 kids together. 3 that's here, 2 of them that's, well, all 3 are in the program, but 1 don't want to play football. I got pregnant with my first baby when I was 14 years old, and I dropped out of high school. I got pregnant with my second baby as a senior. I dropped out again. I ended up going to PSC, getting my diploma because I went and took the GED test. They told me I was too smart to get a GED. Ended up going to college. I got 2 degrees. And so my whole point is, if you put your mind to it, you can do whatever you want. There's going to be times that you're going to make decisions that you really don't agree with, but it's too late. You already made the decision, so you just got to move forward. But there's always a plan B to your plan A. There's always a route, another route that you can take. Even if you are getting lost, say for example, you go into somebody else's house, you're using your GPS, you turn down the road street, it's gonna reroute you. You have that own, that same reroute within yourself. You just got to know how to use it. And if you are looking for a support system and you don't have that support system at home, sometimes you just have to reach out to somebody else and get that same support. When I was younger, when older women would talk to me, I never got an attitude. I always took in what they said, even if I didn't want to. And some of that stuff I was ended up able to focus on later in life. So when someone is speaking to you or trying to give you some advice, don't turn that advice away. Don't get snarky, don't get an attitude. Let that dwell in your spirit, because that's something that may come up later that may help you along your way. And it may help you help somebody else along the way. So just always remember that just because you make a bad decision, it doesn't have to be the end of the road. It doesn't have to be the end of your dreams. Any dream can come true as long as you put in the work. Thank you.
I am going to ask Coach Terrell to stay here and Coach Kennedy to come forward and Coach Palmer. And one of the things that is important to me are the academics that we reward children. And so many times in the urban core, in the inner city, we applaud touchdowns, but we don't applaud honor roll. We applaud tackles, but we don't honor scientific advancement. And so in order to get a great job, you don't have to go to college, young people. You don't have to get a degree or a PhD. That's up to you. You want whatever field, you have to find a field. I just tell you, Coach Palmer make more money than I do, and the money I make, because I ain't never had nothing to do with me going to college. And I make my money because my daddy made me get up early one day and go on a construction site and learn how to build a house. And they taught me how to build a building. And so, no matter what somebody thinks about me, they can write whatever they want to write in the paper. They can't stop me from making money because I have a skill set. And so you have to get that skill set, whether it's an HVAC, whether it's plumbing, whether it's an accountant, whether it's a teacher, a brick mason, a cybersecurity. You can do it, but you gotta decide. The worst thing in the world for you to say is, I don't know what I want to do. In a real developed world, you decide as a young person what you want to do. And you work on it. You work on it day in and day out. And a part of that is being disciplined and doing what you have to do. So one of the things that we're going to do, and I want everybody to know that everybody's going to get a nice award. One thing that we do in District 3, one thing we do in Tiger Nation, is we always have good gifts. And I can just tell you, your gifts ain't free. I can just tell you. They were paid for. I tell you, and they were sacrificed. And there was a lot of effort being put forth in getting on it. But we certainly want to recognize our academic young people first. And academic people, you're going to come up, and you're going to get an award, and everybody's going to get an award, and everybody's going to get a trophy. But before we go into our meal, we are going to come up, and we're going to recognize the young people who turned in their report cards. So, Coach Enrico, would you come up and stand here? And so, I mean, I'll tell you the things that we are going to recognize. We have tablets. I don't know if switches or academic, Coach Palmer, but I think there are. I think we're going to give out computers. $600 computer, I think we're going to give those out. And absolutely, we're going to give out, what's this, Coach Palmer? An Xbox. And Coach Palmer decided on the Xbox that he went on and put in another couple hundred dollars so you can buy your game. So that's good. Now, if you didn't turn your report card, you may well stop saying it. Because it ain't gonna work if you didn't turn in your report card. So we're gonna recognize the girls first. They're gonna come here, and Coach Shamika, will you help me with our first girl?
Miracle Green.
Thanks, Miracle. Shoot right this way, man. Good. Come on, Adam. my goddaughter.
I knew you were here for a reason.
I need a drum.
Kennedy Proctor. Nikayla Bonham. Azaria Houston.
Thank you. Give it up for all of the young ladies who work real hard academically.
Jasmine Hill.
I think Coach Sherrell did a lot more tutoring this year than football because he has a lot of young people who have achieved in school, and that's really what is important. So. Come on up, Terrell, and let's recognize some of the great work of the young people on the line. And we're going to say the all A's for last, Terrell.
Okay. The academic award to me was like the best award. I mean, I wasn't a super athlete. I played on the team with Paul Long. But I made sure my grades were straight, and that's all that mattered. So I was a stickler for my kids turning in their report cards. Some of them did, some of them didn't. But this is gonna be the result of it, okay? First up, we got Mr. Remichael Bell. Hurry up, Mike. Keyshawn Bettis. Come on, hustle up, Keyshawn. Charles Bullard. Mr. Stephen Calhoun. Cam Gibson. Mr. Jacaden Griffin. TJ Hankins. Pablo Johnson. Chris Lett Jr. Up, Chris. Quan Leverett. Thank you. Denzel Locke. Kermit. So, Coach Breeze, you got some competition. Eric Long. Eric. Junior Mills. Carlos Moore. Kermit, Carlos. Kermit. Clint Murphy. Latavius Pratt. Is Pratt here? Pratt not here. Freeland Patterson. No Freeland. Larry Rice. What's up, the other day? TJ Robinson. A.T. Robinson. Cameron Smith. You know, he. Todd Starworth. Corday Watley. B.J. Wiggins. K.J. Williams. No, I'm sorry. Hey, what K.J. at? He was honest with me in the hallway, he said he didn't turn his report card. Sit down, boy. Jaleel Wilson. Jace Wright. My top three on my team as far as grades go. First up, we have Mr. Isaiah Sanders. AKA Bruno Mars. Hey, he gonna leave the door open, guys. All right, next up, Mr. Paul Lawrence Jr. Super dude. Last weekend, he was inducted into the Lamplighters organization. Smart kid. Yeah, good athlete. And finally, Mr. Jacob Perkins. AKA Reed. He was our top student, getting a $600 computer. Hey, Perk, you better not be looking at plays on that computer.
Jacob ain't more than a pretty face.
Good job. Thank you. Give it up to all the academic team. Next up, we have Coach Kenny. Coach Kenny, they only have one.
I'll tell you what.
Oh, yeah. Please. It's okay for the little baby. Anybody on the two know better, but little babies can't help it.
They can joke all they want to. I tell you what, I only have one person to turn in their report card, and he was proud. Mr. Larry Sim. Larry said, "Coach, I made all eight."
That computer is bigger than him. So at this time, young people that have gotten the academic award, we want you to know it's special. You got some things. Everybody's going to get some awards before the end of the night. But please value it, take care of it, appreciate it, pay it forward. At this time, we're going to call our Mighty Mike coach up, Coach Trey Barner, and if all the Mighty Mike coaches will please come forward. Mighty Mike coach.
First coach, Dennis Stallworth.
Coach Clint Murphy. Yeah. Coach Prim. Coach Charlie. Coach Tavion. Coach Dominique. Coach Mike. And Coach Larry Williams.
Tayshawn Mack. Keyshawn Prim. Tavion Jenkins. Bryson Bibbs. Colin Kennedy. Keystone Batone. Gabriel Charles. Nathan Leverett. Tamarcus Jenkins. Jimmy. Dakota and Dante Smith. Dwayne Silas. Maurice Thomas. Blessing Rick. Jamarion Jason Young.
Tazi Williams. Vince Johnson. Debbie. Nicole. Zaylin Lee. Hans Robinson. Oh. Josiah. Carrion Williams. Give it up for our Mighty Mike football team. Coach Kenny Reed and all the Mighty Mike coaches and the Mighty Mike players, line up to our right. Coach Lewis Purify. Coach Maurice Dunn. Coach Ken. Coach Monte. And Coach Slane.
Michael Foster. Eric Jenkins. Timothy Evans. Davion Hardy. Courtney Beasley.
I don't know him.
Come up. All the mic coaches and the mic players.
Y'all give it up for the 10U champs. I'm gonna go off script a little bit. We've been in the coaches chat since 2019. And it's always something with these coaches. I mean, whenever somebody's going through something, like y'all keep James Watson in your prayers. He's got some stuff going on. But this coaches group, man, has helped me a lot. I mean, we can talk about anything. I mean, some of the stuff that we talk about, we might end up having to sleep on the couch. But y'all will never know. But let me start out with Coach Brian Stallworth. Coach R.A. Houston. Coach Chris Lett, Senior. Coach Von Crumpton. Hey, this next coach, y'all want his real name or y'all want his nickname? I ain't gonna do him like that. Coach Jabbar Graham.
What's the nickname?
Hey, y'all get with Coach on y'all own and find out what his nickname is. Coach Greg Perkins. Coach Sonny Coldfeld. Coach Terrence Anker.
I got it.
All right, first up, Mr. Paul Lawrence Jr. Give it up. Mr. Kenneth Mills. Yeah, you don't like the name. Kenneth Jr. Mills. CJ Watley. Stephen Calhoun. Ronald Thornton. Keyshawn Bettis. Mr. Denzel Locke.
Thank you.
Mr. A.T. Robinson.
Thank you.
Mr. Materian Locke. Mr. Katie Griffin. Mary Williams, Danny Williams, Jatavius Pratt, Cam Gibson, Charles Bullock, Jacob Perkins, Glenn Murphy, Juan Demaret, Connor Coldfeld. Callie Coldpepper. Isaiah. Sanders. Michael Bell. James Wright. Chris Lett. Amari Hankins. Carlos Moore. Jaleel Wilson, and Mr. Larry Wright.
Let's give it up for the Mike football team. At this time, Coach Shamika is coming up to do the cheerleading. And boy, we need y'all to respect the cheerleaders and the girls. All girl cheerleaders, please come forward. Stand to the right. Coach is the girl.
Let's start with Mighty Mike cheerleaders. All Mighty Mike cheerleaders. That's 4, 5, 6. Come up. Come up.
Head coach Shalana Aiken, Shalana, thank you. Coach Elaine and her girl. Kenny and Nelly. Give it up for the 2022
Last month, they hit a match with 160 coaches and stated that they will step up to the plate and call out the drugs. I need all my
quick, everybody, while we're getting special awards, I'd like to recognize some of my guys whenever they come back home. So I want to recognize this young man. People say he couldn't play football, he's too slow, he'll never make it. He's now a starting tight end at Southern University, Mr. Greg Perkins Jr. Thank you. I'm just waiting for the tickets on the banquet over there.
Hey, LeGreg, just walk around the house now with your shirt on.
First award we have, we always go to the scene and like trying to find a player. And Larry, well, Michael Foster, we have no center. He stepped up. Offensive player, Larry. To the system. Kahari. 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 academic Larry Simmons. Big defensive lineman, German Prill boy. Yeah. Offensive player, Jones. Title award will go to Malik Snyder.
Get to the kids, I need to recognize my team. This reads, Coach Shea, thank you for handling team mom duties for two teams. You took care of us all while working two jobs, cooking Alfredo for Pablo, and fussing at his dog Dash. Stop barking. You're the best. Always. Coach Real and Team U staff. All right, best defensive back, Mr. Ronald Thorne. Yeah. Best defensive lineman, Mr. Denzel Locke. Yeah. Most improved, Mr. Chris Lett Jr. Best offensive back, Mr. Kenneth Mims, Jr. Sportsmanship Award, Cordae Watman. Best offensive line, Mr. Carlos Moore. Academic Award, Mr. Jacob Perkins. Yeah. Come on, Kermit, Carlos, Kermit. Hey, 10 U players, see us when we get some, when we get done, okay?
You are a leader. Other people, take a look out here. People watch you. They want to be like you. And if you're just running and yelling and screaming and not sitting down, they're going to do it. That's why you are who you are, because you have discipline. Your attitude determines your altitude, all right? So we got something special for y'all. We got a special guest coming in. But I'm going to tell you, if you don't want to be disciplined, this is the wrong place for you. Yep. Every day we open the doors, we're going to have children coming in and coming out. But you have to be responsible, because look at all these volunteers. I tell you what, look at our staff. No one gets paid. I don't get paid. None of them get paid. It's because of what we believe in you. But nobody wants to deal with someone that's not disciplined and doesn't listen. And that's the reality. You have to do it. You have to be able to go on the field, go in the gym, and be able to be respectful even without your parents being there. And if someone doesn't tell you that you need to pull up your pants, don't sag them, respect adults, if they don't tell you that, then they're giving you a disservice. Because the reality of what's happened, guys, is not happening just when you're 16 and 17 and 18 years old. They stereotype you when you're in the third grade. They create prison beds by the third grade referral discipline form. That's how they do it. That's exactly how they set it up. Here's the reality, guys. Less than 1% of y'all are gonna go Division I. Less. Five Forks just went to the state. I guarantee they don't have four kids in Division I. Guaranteed. So there are thousands and thousands. You're not gonna have, yep. On a good year, we may have what, Lewis, six D1, maybe?
Five Forks got one D1.
One D1, thank you. One Division I player, one! So the reality, in 10 years, you gotta get a job. No one's gonna hire you. When you come in my office, you know what my memory will be? My memory will be, how did you act when you were 10? And my staff, they'll be looking at, you know, those kids are out of control. All right, so y'all deserve the best, we're gonna give you the best. We're not here to lecture, we want you to have a good Christmas. We want to reward you. I want y'all to give it up for these coaches who volunteer for y'all, give it up. So here's the reality. Hopefully everybody gets to give. We got a special guest that's about to come. I thank Mike if he's ready. We got a special guest that's gonna come in, just wanted to come in and say hello to y'all. And he's about to walk in the door. A lot of y'all might not know a lot about hockey, but here he comes. Come on up, y'all give it up for Mike. Mike's gonna come in and do it. Mike made this happen for us tonight. And he really wanted y'all to meet this special guest. Usually how Leroy looks, but it's all good. Y'all give it up for Mike. Mike made this happen for us tonight.
Thank you. Really glad to have you here, and very happy and very thankful to have the opportunity to host you tonight. We really appreciate everybody being here. So, does anybody know who this is? Do you know who the Ice Flyers are? It's a bird, you're right. But do you know who the Ice Flyers are?
No.
Okay. Who are they?
A hockey team.
Hockey team, there you go. Yes. So we won the championship this past year. It's our fourth title in the last 9 years. So it's one of the best minor league hockey teams out there in the town, in the Southern Professional Hockey League. But this is Maverick. So we wanted to make sure that, you know, we want to get you down here and get out on the ice. Is anybody here ice skated?
Yes.
Oh, wow. We need to get you back down here. Has anybody seen Coach May ice skate?
No, I'm skating.
Yeah.
So we're going to, we also want to extend an invitation to come down and ice skate. And anytime the rest of the season, we do have some holiday skates going on. And then also, we're going to work in partnership with Coach and your organization. We've got the Sun Belt Basketball Championships coming up.
The greatest difference you can make is making a difference in the life of a child.